Black students better, or are blacks better because of integration? My answer to that would be no. And I would qualify that by saying, are they exposed to more opportunities? Yes. But the assumption is that in segregated schools, you had poor teachers, and that wasn't the case. We had outstanding teachers who held you to the highest degree of accountability. Once integration occurred, we lost those teachers who didn't mind making it a hands-on kind of approach in caring about you and having the highest expectations. Because at that time, there were still people who believed the myths that blacks were inferior intellectually and otherly, and that you'll be glad to be able to have a janitorial job or become a maid or become some type of assistant. That type of thought was still prevalent in that kind of a transition. And so that's why it was crucial to have people at home who kept saying, you can do this. You can be anything that you want to be. As a matter of fact, you might even be president one day. And little they know, there would be a black president one day.
What is your lasting impression from your time spent from a student all the way up to an administrator over the course of your 60-some years?
I feel I got a good education. My qualifier is because of the start I had in the segregated schools and because of the type of parents I had, I knew how to read, knew how to write, knew numbers before I even went to school. And then the rest of it was the socialization, to end up socializing with people who were different than I was.
So that part of the integration was crucial for you?
Yes, and I think it's crucial for most people because we don't live in isolation. And we may act like it, but we really don't. And so having that ability to have that kind of interaction is very positive. But I think the takeaway for me is that Topeka Public Schools is a great place. It has a storied past. Some of it may be good, some of it not so good, overall pretty good, but it can be better. And my hope for this community, my hope for the legacy of Brown, is that we realize mistakes of the past. We accept the premise that all kids can learn, all kids should have hope, and hope should not be snuffed out, and that as educators, as politicians, as people who are keepers of the dream, should do everything we can to make sure it comes to realization. What black kids need, white kids need as well, or any other kid, they need committed people who push them to be the very best they can be without judging them. And really, teachers, principals shouldn't even be called that. We should be called a Ways and Means Committee, always looking for ways and means to help our students be as successful as they possibly can.